Hey guys, how's it going? This is Adrian. We're still on. We're gonna have to put that on hold. Asking Grace here. Hey guys, how's it going? So right now, I'm excited because I'm getting ready for the Super Secret Zombie shoot. I just got two. I'm getting ready to set up two gongs. And I just painted my AMSEC Static Popper. I'm gonna be doing durability tests on that, so let's go and check it out. So, check it out. So that's an AMSEC Static Popper. And it's painted pink because that's going to be the communal color that lets everybody know that is free for all to shoot. So we'll see how it goes. I am going to be doing a video just based on that, and check it out. There's no better way to test a gong or a steel target than letting a whole bunch of people just shoot it. And I will be asking people to avoid AP rounds, because AP rounds will pretty much damage any steel target. But I expect maybe a few to hit it, so check out that video, and I bet you're going to want to go get one. So let's go ahead and continue getting ready for the zombie shoot. Right now what I'm working on is I picked up these target brackets. Sorry. From a company called Blue Steel Targets. And their brackets, I picked a different kind of bracket from them. One pair of brackets. You use 3/4-inch conduit and below your legs. And it got slots for 2x4s to go across. And the second pair of brackets that I got slide into the 2x4. It's got a hook, so you can just drop your chain. So, I want to show you right now. So, here we go. I think this right here, I cut it in half, so it's two pieces now. This is like $1.50. A pair of these is $24.99. So for $25, plus $2, so it's less than $30, you got your legs. You don't got to pay $200, so. Here's how the legs are. So pretty much is all your legs, and I'm gonna continue this when I get it set up with the other brackets. All right, guys. I like this this is pretty cool. I wanna show it to you guys. I put it together. It's very easy to put together. It's very simple. I don't know why they didn't do this a long time ago, but check it out. Say hi, Jeremiah.
Hi.
All right. So you buy these as a set, this one and this one, $24.99, and I believe the same price for these. And these right here, oh man, I painted the floor. These right here are hooks that pretty much just let you hang these. Why is that cool? Because if you blow out the chain, the only thing you got to worry about as far as nuts is this. And you can probably figure something else with this too. I mean, I'm going to make sure to take some tools out there if I do have to change this. But so there you go, very very simple. And I want to take it out to the Super Secret Zombie shoot here in a few days, in a couple days.
Hey Fernando.
Yes.
I like zombies.
You like zombies?
Yeah.
You'll learn to hate them. Okay, I said you'll learn to hate them. So there you go. Isn't that pretty cool? All right, so the hooks, just that's like this 2x4 to hold the chain up. It's worth it. Why? I just spent like 10 minutes removing the bolts from another piece of wood and then putting it back in a different piece of wood after drilling holes. I'm not going to just use hooks. But I only have one set of hooks. So, but yep, check it out. So, I use the same brackets, but on this one, I didn't have another set of brackets to hang, so I had to drill. It's kind of a pain in the butt. But you know, I can live with that. These are definitely worth it though. So you got one set up where you got this, and then you got this one right here where you're using all of the brackets. It's kind of hard to do this when you're babysitting your nieces, right? Or nephews. Guys, how's it going? I just arrived here at the super secret zombie shoot. There's a lot of people here, so it's gonna be a little bit weird kind of being on selfie mode here when I record my videos. But you guys, so here's my tent, a little baby tent. In the past couple times that I've came here, here's my awesome truck. I've brought this huge cabin type of tent. But it's just a pain in the butt to set up by myself, so I didn't bring it. Two, I think I tore it last time. And three, the winds really move that thing around. So, in my Pelican case, let's go ahead and head up to the shooting table that I just finished up earlier. So I just got here to the line. Made it here a little bit late because they got the range hot now, so I can't set up my targets. But and let me show you the line, how it is so far. Here's my shooting station right here. My canopy. Got my table set up. My bag. Lid slid. Some targets over there, some targets over here. So, there's the line right here. And here's our range. Waiting for the line to go cold. I was told 30 minutes ago, it's been like an hour. I wanna shoot already. I got my targets ready in the back of the truck so I can go take gas unless it go cold. It's a nice morning though. pistol. Here.
I want to be up here when it's front range because look at all these guns up there. I left today. I'm going to look forward to it for quite a while.
Go!
So far, it's gone too. That's more. Alright.
Everybody setting up the targets. Almost an hour. Close ceasefire.
Hey guys, how's it going? I am tired. I don't know what time it is. 2 p.m.? I don't know. I've been shooting this whole time since I got here, and I'm tired, so I'm taking a break. Probably going to take a nap a little bit. I may take a nap in my truck because I brought a small tent. And I feel like laying in it. It's kind of hot in there, too. So I'm going to take a nap in my truck. Drink like 5 or 6 of these and then I want to go shoot again. Just kidding. I'm just gonna chill now. I'm just gonna drink this one, take a nap, wake up later on when the sun sets down a bit, see what's gonna happen. I don't know what's gonna happen. It's been a while since I've been to one of these, so I'm just tired, but it's fun though. I shot 500 rounds of 5.56 so far, and it was awesome. It was awesome. I mean, in only a few short hours, I was just, it was so much fun. I shot 500 rounds of 5.56, 300 rounds of 9. I brought my M&P 1522. Rifle, and I forgot to bring 22. What the fuck? Bah. Sorry. But so much fun though. Shot my LCP, shot about 60 rounds through it. Now about 70, 80 rounds through it. So, I'm pretty beat now. I'm here by myself. My wife didn't come. She ain't gonna like the little tent that I brought though, so she would have came out about the big tent. You know, the big old 14-person tent, but the people that I've met so far have been great. My neighbors, if my neighbors up in a shooting range are pretty cool. They've been pretty, it's been pretty organized here. That's what I like about this place. This place is very safe. They call ceasefires. They have a flag that goes way up. It's a red flag. If it's up, the range is hot. So if you pull up to the range, you want to know if it's hot or cold, you look at the flag. If it's down, it's cold. And of course they announce it too, so this, they're very good at that. And I like it. Sometimes it kind of sucks. Sometimes it kind of sucks when you shoot with so many people because, you know, it's an hour and a half between cold and hot. So if you just get here and they just went hot, you have to wait like about an hour before they go cold to put up your targets. But you know what though? I've waited about an hour and 15 minutes and I just chilled. Set up my tent, my table, and I just chilled. Ooh, what up, babe? Alright, I'm gonna take a nap now.
They were having some kind of bicycle race in Newport when he got really wasty bad. So, like, there was a shitload of people on the roof, and we ended up making friends with most of them, and then we were trying to hook Robert up with, like, a woman who's 50 years old. He was like,
yeah, but she
had having it.
She had a massive.
She had a rack.
She had a rack.
Yeah.
Do you want to kind of go inside? I'm going to load real quick.
Oh, shit.
Say hi. Hold on.
This is Facebook. You're live on Facebook.
You need a live
on? This is Mr. Lone Wolf, the infamous motherfucking Mr. Lone Wolf. And he brought his fucking chupacabra. Look at it. Look at this motherfucker.
You know what I got?
This gives the nastiest, most disgusting flashes I've ever seen.
Nice.
You want to fire a couple?
I didn't know that. I've seen that.
Go for it. Let's go.
Well, so you can do like, it's the whole thing.
Yeah.
Just like normal.
So you take it like this. Stick it in.
Strip it out.
No pressure, out. But everyone's waiting for you.
And then put it back in.
How many people?
Yeah.
20.
Okay, guys. Hold on. Yeah. Keep going hard. Eyes and ears, please.
Eyes and ears.
Okay, just keep recording this one. Please.
Ready? Yeah, turn off the light.
Go ahead. Watch this. This is so cool.
Keep the camera. Going hot.
Fuck.
Fucking A.
Little fireball.
Oh, have mercy.
I think I sat back real quick. Hang on. A couple more. What do you guys think of the chupacabra?
AR pistol? Oh, AR.
It's got a brake on it, so it throws a...
That's pretty fucking good.
Actually, if I were really going to do that, I would have brought my AR pistol.
Oh, is it the top? The top of your brake?
Yeah.
No, the other side.
Yeah, you know you
I got the same brake on my...
It's like a brake.
Going hot.
Eyes on ears, please.
Yeah.
Works good.
Just for featureless.
Works good.
Deplorable!
Fuck.
Make America great again!
Yeah!
One more.
Go ahead.
Woo!
One more time.
Fuck it, I'm buying
that. Yeah, you guys ready for another one? Another volley?
I only got 10 more rounds.
Sure.
Are you going to bump fire?
I can.
Like bump fire it out. Bump fire it out.
It makes you night blind with all that flash.
I know. Pretty intense, huh?
Yeah, it is.
You got, like, Flip, I don't know if
that flip is after the
handle
you got on there.
Oh shit.
There you go.
I want to fire off some. Live.
Alright.
Going hot!
Justin, you ready?
For what?
You get a bump fire?
I thought we were going to do another bump.
The people want to know.
Let's do another volley with bump fire.
Ball function.
Yeah. I only got 10 more rounds, so. Hopefully this is it. Volley. Well, I mean,
yeah. Me.
Gonna do one more? You got 10 more?
I got 10 more.
So I don't.
My favorite bag.
No.
I've been getting that, like, you know, kind of getting the seed has been planted, you know what I mean? I'm starting to. I don't know a whole lot, honestly, either. But this is a Jukka gun, right? No, this is Globals. Oh, oh, oh. You just let me shoot it. Think it's a Moza with a Monte Carlo stock on it. Huge, like, that break, man. Yeah, nice. Clear. Was that bump fire? Okay, clear. Was that bump fire? All right. Or was that next? Really fast stringer. Go.
I was trying to bump fire with a break. Let's stop this. We doing a volley?
Yeah.
All right.
Volley. Volley. Let's go.
Here, I'll hold on to this so I get these guys. Thanks.
Fire Mosin? No. Who can bump fire their Mosin?
If you can bump fire Mosin.
Alex, you look like a fucking toilet handle.
We doing a volley?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How come I'm the only one here?
Oh, crap.
Michael, light on.
Lights off.
Okay. Race hot. Eyes and ears, please. Eyes and ears.
You guys ready?
Fucking flash is stupid big. It's like it's.
Oh, take time, yeah, man. You gotta. You have to find an instructor.
I ready.
Yeah.
Body naked.
I got it on washer.
You have it on what?
Washer.
On what?
Oh, it's amazing. It's insane.
Oh, the washer. Yeah. Did you bring it?
Washer.
Okay, let me back up.
Yeah, you want to see it?
Yeah. Maybe I'm going to head back down in a little bit. But yeah, I want to check it out tomorrow. I'll come back and find it. I'm a little bit further down that way.
Hey, do you know how to load a motion or what?
A couple of the guys from
there
are going to be meeting.
No, I haven't seen them in a while because I moved to
hot!
Where the fuck up?
Okay. I'm recording.
Not yet, but it's in the works.
Nice!
And that was a big reason for moving there.
Nice.
Like, I wanted to move out of L.A.
Yeah.
But, like, I'm nice. Like, out of the question.
Inside. How did your liberal roommate think about that? You moving out there?
She's kind of coming around.
Is she?
Yeah.
Hey, did you guys hear about that fat-free bacon company?
What?
The fat-free bacon company?
We moved there.
Did you guys hear about it? No. They went out of business.
Say when. Go.
Gosh.
She started to kind of come around.
Lord. Who's next?
I got one right here. I want to shoot.
Yeah, there's one right there.
So it's morning time now. And I couldn't sleep very well. It was cold. I'm not used to being in such a small tent. But I did get a nice surprise.
My girl showed up.
So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I gotta get a bigger tent. I have a big tent, but I ripped it last time. And cushions. I thought I could rough it out like I was 20, but no. I tried sleeping in the truck, but you know it's freezing in there. We have this Mr. Heater here. That thing is hot, especially for this tent. So we kept things simple though. We could use that again, except next time if we do that, we need cushions and a lot more blankets. So yeah, gonna clean up a little bit, maybe do some shooting before the sun comes up too hot, and head out later on. Everybody's up and early. It's 7:30. So gotta head back down. I left my earmuffs. So left my earmuffs, I just figured
I show the camp. There's my little car. Like I said, my wife showed up. A lot of people, huh? All right, guys, so it is Saturday morning. It's 10. We are leaving the Super Freaking Zombie Shoot. Now while I'm leaving, the party here is just getting started. But you know, I got here I was yesterday early morning, and I've shot a lot of rounds, so I'm pretty beat. So, you know, I usually like to get to places before the crowd does, you know, it's just less busy. But what sucks is they're going to do, tonight I believe they're going to do a zombie movie. I believe they're going to have a potluck. And so that's going to be pretty cool. You know, people that are going to be there get food, people bring food, people eat food. And there's going to have Mosin Madness. That is going to be awesome. I did get a taste of that yesterday when me and Lone Wolf, Andrew, and a few others were out there shooting Mosins and just trying to get a big flash, and it was so awesome. So I'm gonna miss that, but this event is just full of great people. I would like to thank Bert. He invited me over for some beer, to have data cake at night, and you know, had a couple of burgers there, and you know, we all just chilling on a bonfire, having some family wholesome friendly jokes. But we had a good time. It was awesome. So I can't wait to hang out with those guys again. They're a great bunch of guys. And every time I come here, though, I get motivated to buy an RV. Oh, and if you're confused why I'm driving a little, I'm not driving the truck. It's because, again, my wife didn't show up. So I'm driving the car in and out of this place because it's pretty rough. And if you don't know the road, you will mess up the car. Some washes and stuff. But I can't wait to Super Seeker Zombie Shoot 8.0, because this is 7.5, so I believe it's gonna be 8.0 for the next one. So I can't wait. Always a good time, and yeah, can't wait to see you guys again, and stay safe out there. Hey guys, how's it going? So thank you for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I tried to do my best to record, you know, but between shooting and just hanging out with some awesome people, I did the best that I could, and I hope it was enough. If you guys have any suggestions, let me know. I really want to thank some people that I met there. I want to thank Bert for inviting me to their bonfire. We had some great conversations. Andrew, Lone Wolf, all them guys, just awesome dudes. And I just can't wait to go again, and you know, not just for the shooting, but
you know, to meet all those guys again. And one thing I wanted to point out, the reason I'm making this final video as this video as the outro for this is, you know, look at the videos and notice how beautiful the place looks. It's a very beautiful landscape. It's a very well-kept area still, and we want to keep it that way. Therefore, please clean up after yourself and take a little bit extra. You know, there's a lot of people that leave the brass, think, oh, it's going to be a reloader picking it up. No, pick it up, and if somebody wants to get it, give it to them, or somebody's willing to offer to do it beforehand, but don't just leave it. Let's do our best to not get shut down, and let's do our best that these kind of places are still available for kids, grandchildren, and future generations. Unfortunately, there's a lot of bad spots out there, like Hodge Road. It's so well known that it gets abused, and it's going to get shut down eventually. And I would really be heartbroken if this location here falls in the same fate. So let's do our best, and I will see you guys next time. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll put up more videos. Have a good one.